विष्णुत प्रविश्य मम वाचमिमा प्रसुप्तां सञ्जीवयत्य शिलशक्तिधर अन्यांश्च हस्तचरणश्रवणत्वदानी भगवते पुरुषाय Dikshitar had the rare opportunity of getting exposed to Hindustani Uttaradi music also, as he stayed in Kashi for 5 years with his guru Chidambaranatha Yogi. He has imbibed the best, he has culled out the best in Hindustani music, and amazingly he has brought some authentic Hindustani ragas, which are Deshiya ragas, they are called imported from Hindustani, Deshiya ragas, into Carnatic system in such a way that it no more sounds like Hindustani. Yet, you know that it is from Hindustani. That is the way it is moulded, it is shaped, and it is assimilated into the system. That Carnatic music system is so great, so all-encompassing and all-embracing, so magnanimous and large-hearted, that it can accept anything into its fold, make its own. That's most important. It is not like cut and paste. It's not like patchwork. It's not that you have a border, you cut it, you like that border, there is a, the sari, plain sari, you attach it to that. And everybody knows that it is an attachment. But it is not so here. That is the greatness of Dikshitar's music. So he takes something, he only imbibes, he doesn't copy. He doesn't copy at all. And so beautifully, what you call Yaman in Hindustani music, that has been called Yamuna Kalyani, which I will teach tomorrow. And Vrindavani, Vrindavani is the name given here. But Vrindavana Saranga is also a name prevalent, which goes with the song, with the name of the raga. Vrindavani, he calls it Vrindavani here, but in the text of the song, he uses the word Vrindavana Saranga. In the very Pallavi itself, he uses the word Vrindavana Saranga. That means it's a synonym of Vrindavani then. And it is a Janya of 22nd Mela. He has composed two songs in this raga. One is that famed, yes, what M.S. Amma has popularized. And then this is the other one. Which one? Both are almost the same. When I talk of Vijavanti, you have two songs supposed to be composed by Dikshitar in that, Chetashri Balakrishnam and Akhilandeshwari. Akhilandeshwari for sure is not his creation. Chetashri is in this text also, it is most authentic. It is so much like Carnatic style, it is an adaptation of the Jai Jai Vanti. Jaya Jaya Dvija Jai Jai Dva Dvitva of Jayakara. So he calls it Dvija, Dvija Vanti. Dvija also means twice born, a Brahmana or a bird. Both are twice born. So Dvija has that very special meaning also. So there for sure you can say that Akhilandeshwari is not the Dvijavanti conceived by Dikshitar, as you find it in Chetashri Balakrishnam. I had given that also one of the 16 songs. Irlinga. Chetashri, perhaps I just missed out. There are so many now. I type. But here it is the same Vrindavana Saranga. Not much of a difference. That Nishada has to be lightened. It is almost straight and only the Jarugamukha is more here. You can see the original, if you have taken a photo of that, you see a lot of Jarugamukhas here. So which is the hallmark of Hindustani style. Of course you have the other Nokku and all that added to that to make it Carnaticized Vrindavani. So that is it. Gandhara also. Vigaritha Prayoga, which may make you think that how different it is from Sri Radha. Sarima Parisa Sani Poma Rigaritha. But Rigaritha he does not use very often. Only in the very take-off Sangati of the Pallavi he uses Gandhara. And once again in the Charana. Apart from that, only twice he uses, but a very special way, in a very very special way it comes there. Not like you find in Sri Radha at all. You forget Sri Radha, you forget Madhyamavati. First thing you have to do is you have to forget those two Radhas when you sing Vrindavan. Okay? సంప్రదాయజ్ఞులు పాడుతున్నారు. ఋషభ ఇస్ ఎ ప్రామినెంట్ లో మొట్టమొదట ఋషభము నెత్తి నిషాదము దీర్ఘముగను అవరోహణమున నిషాదము మొదటిని నెత్తి ఋషభము దీర్ఘముగను గనిపించి ఉండుట వలన ఈ రాగమునకు ఋషభ నిషాదములే రంజనములనిచ్చి జీవస్వర న్యాసస్వరములని పూర్వాచార్యుల అభిప్రాయము. వెరీ క్లియర్లీ. And then ఈ రాగమునకు స్వల్ప గాంధారము గలదని సంప్రదాయజ్ఞుల సమ్మతము. స్వల్ప గాంధారము, యు కెన్ అండర్స్టాండ్ తెలుగు, లిటిల్ బిట్ ఆఫ్ గాంధార, స్ప్రింకిల్ ఇట్ ఇస్ వన్ ఆర్ టూ గాంధార హియర్ ఆఫ్ దే ఎటులనిన పై చెప్పిన ప్రయోగములను గాంధార ప్రయోగములను గీత కీర్తన సంచారుల వలన స్పష్టమవును. హౌ యూ హ్యావ్ టు సింగ్? యూ హ్యావ్ టు సింగ్ సీ ద లక్ష్య, హౌ ఇట్ షుడ్ బి యూస్డ్. ఇఫ్ యూ సింగ్ ఇట్ ఇన్ ఎ డిఫరెంట్ వే, ఇట్ సౌండ్స్ డిఫరెంట్ అండ్ డస్ నాట్ సౌండ్ లైక్ బృందావన సారంగ. Only that up, the star is given. It has to be sung from above. So can sing sweet, or just leave it and say Soundararajam. So one has to be very, very careful. If we add something of our own, it may mar the dhyana, marga of Dikshitar.
Da, 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 da
And he has to be Soundararajam. Actually, Soundararajam is a Sanskrit word. Soundararajam, he uses Ganti. Ranganayati, he uses that term which is ungrammatical. In Sanskrit, there is no word as Nayati. Okay. Nayika is the word. In Sanskrit, you cannot have a Nayati but Nayika. When can you? Dikshitar has used both Nayika and Nayati. When he says Ranganayati, Ranganayati Sametam, because that is the name of that goddess. Badarivana Nayika Mula. Badarivana Mula Nayika Sahita. Bhadrakalisha. In Chakravarna composition, Akshayalinga Vibho, he uses the correct term. Badarivana Mula Nayika. Not that he doesn't know Sanskrit. He knows excellent Sanskrit. Some people object and I have given an answer by always. It's the Rudhyartha, Rudinama. Likewise, Soundararajam. Soundararajam Aashraye, I resort to Gajabrinda Avana. Gajabrinda Avana. Avana is to protect the Brinda, herd of Gaja, elephant. And Saranga Varadaraja. And he is not Sarangapani here. He is Saranga Vara. Sarangana Varam Dadati. Varam Dadati. The one who bestows upon the Sarangas, that is the deer, the flora and fauna are protected by him. The Gajas and Sarangas are protected by the Lord. There are epithets referring to Krishna. There are epithets referring to Rama also. Vishnu also, totally. It's a wholesome Vishnu avatar. Vishnu Rupa. So Soundararajam is Vishnu here. Soundararajam Aashraye Gaja Brinda Avana Saranga Varada Rajam. Rajan Shabda, when it comes, of course, at the end of a samasa, a compound word, it is used as a pullinga shabda, that is akaranta pullinga shabda, like Rama Shabda. So it is not Raja Rajanau Rajanaha, it becomes Rajaha. Rajau Rajaha, like Ramaha Ramo Ramaha, at the end of a compound. So Soundara Raja, Soundara Rajam, that is him, who is Soundara Raja, I resort to. Okay, once again, both the Sangati. Soundara Nanda. You can make a note of it. You have the record. You can practice it.
Nanda,
Nanda, Nanda, More of ma. More of ma. Ma, ma.
Rajam, Rajam, Sundari,
కరాంబుజం మందరధర కరాంబు కర కర ఐ విల్ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ దెన్ యూ హ్యావ్ టు కరెక్ట్ ఇట్ కరాంబుజం ఎస్ ఐ నో మందరధర కరాం కరాంబుజం
Yeah.
Amar Re Sha Vaniye. It is from Sa. Sa is to be bracketed. Ambhuti. Shajja is Sa.
Ambhuti. Thank you.
Feel it. Say to yourself 1,000 times how beautiful it is. Then you will get it. Just like nothing beyond. You should love that. Every note, every sangati. See, when I sing, Kambhu Vidambana Kantam, I feel like stopping. I don't want to sing any further. So beautifully it comes to Shadja. Kambhu Vidambana Kantam, I'll explain the meaning now. Soundararajam Aashraye Gaja Brinda Avana Saranga Varada Varada Rajam Nanda Nandana Rajam. Nanda is Krishna's father. Nanda. Nanda Nandana. Nandam Nandayati. That is the one who gives him joy, gives delight to Nanda. He is the chief of that. So he is the Raja who gives great delight to Nanda. Nanda Nandana Rajam. Nagapattana, he is referring to the place where the deity is Soundararaja. Nagapattanam, our own Nagapattanam. So Nagapattana, Pattana in Sanskrit means city. Nagapattana Rajam. Sundari Rama Rajam, now Vishnu. Rama is Lakshmi. He is the Raja, Lord of Sundari Rama. The beautiful Rama. Nagapattana. Nagapattana is the place where the temple is constructed and the deity there worshipped is Soundararaja. Sundari Rama Rajam, Sura Vinuta Mahi Rajam. Mahi is Bhu Raja. He is also as Rama on the earth. Mahi Raja, or he is the Lord of the earth wherever he is, whatever form. Mahi Raja and Sura Vinuta, saluted by God. And now the series begins wherein you have very beautiful alliteration, the prasa, antyakshara prasa, and all ambuja, lotus. Mandasmita mukhambuja. The mukhambuja, the lotus face, is lit up by a gentle smile always. Mandasmita, not laughter. There are so many ways of laughing. And there is a gentle smile, always adorning his face, lotus face. He has that. Mandara Dhara Karambujam. As Vishnu in his Purma Avatara, he lifted the Mandara Parvata, the very Parvata which was sinking otherwise. Nandakara Nayanambujam. Here Nanda means Ananda. Anandakara. Nandakara Nayanambujam. That is, if you look at his eyes, Nandakara Nayanambuja, the lotus eyes of his, gives great joy, the greatest joy. And Sundaratara Padambuja, the lotus feet, they are so tender, so soft, so rosy, so delicate, so nice. Sundaratara Padambuja, so everything is lotus about him. Look at that. As rosy as lotus, as pink as lotus, as gentle as lotus, as soft as lotus, okay, as colorful as lotus, padambuja, and as fragrant as lotus. Kararavindena padaravindam mukharavinde vinivesayantam. So the poet here also compares every limb of his to a lotus. Kararavindena padaravindam. Only Balakrishna can do it. Nobody try doing it. Sleep, hold your big toe in your hand and try putting it into your mouth. If you can do it, $1 trillion. Can't do it. No yoga patu can do it. Only Yogi Krishna. Yogi Nameshwara Krishna alone can do it. So, that is the description here, Ambuja, Ambuja, Ambuja. Mandasmita Mukhambujam, Mandaradhara Karambujam, Nandakara Nayanambujam, Sundaradhara Padambujam, and it matches with the Antyakshara of Soundararajam Aashraye. And then, Shambara Vairi Janakam. Shambara Vairi. Shambara is Shiva. His Vairi is Manmatha. Manmathasya Janakaha. Manasija Sauta. Sannuta Shuka Shaunakadi Munayaha. Shuka Shaunakada Vedali. Ambarishadi Vidhitam. He is known to sages like Ambarisha. The devotee is like Ambarisha. He can be known only to such, by such devotees. Anadi Guru Guha Muditam. Adi Rahita Guru Guha rejoices in remembering Vishnu. Anadi Guru Guha Muditam. Ambuja Asanadi Mutam. Saluted by the lotus seated Brahma and others. Amaresha Adi Sannutam. Again saluted by Amaresha, Indra and others. Ambudhi Garva Nigraham. Here you have Amavatar. Ambudhi Garva Nigraham. When he wanted to cross the ocean, he could not do it. He slept there on Darbha, Darbha Chayana. He was on the floor, on the ground for 3 days. But he did not comply to his request and prarthana. Then he took the Brahmastra. He wanted to dry up the ocean. Then he came up. Ambudhi comes. He says, I am such a huge and vast and expansive mass, you know. I am really sorry that I delayed, but tell me what is the idea. So, there were demons far away and he directed his Brahmastra towards them and he killed them. But he punished Ambudhi. He took means it's over. Ka katha bana sandhane jyaghosheneva sarvasatya. Ambudhi is ocean. Ambudhi. Ambu in Sanskrit means water. The receptacle, repository of water. Ambudhi. Ambu dhatte. That is the explanation. Ambu dhatte iti ambudhi. That which possesses water is ambudhi. Garva nigraham. Anrita jada dukkha apaham. This apaha shabda is used several times by Dikshitar in several compositions. Apaha is to set aside, remove, do away with anrita, falsehood, jadatva. Jada is slumber. Slothfulness, dullness, that is, for everything, that dullness, anrita, jada, dukkha, grief caused by anrita and jadatva, it can be taken that way also, or anrita dukkha, jadatva dukkha and dukkha itself, all these are removed by falsehood, sullu, anrita, jada, dukkha, apaham. Kambu vidambana kantam. Kambu is shankha. Vidambana kanta. Conch shaped. Neck. Here vidambana is to put to shame. Mock at Kambu. Vidambana Kantam. What is Kambu? Before this neck. So beautiful it is. Kambu Vidambana Kanta. And here again you have a series of epithets ending with Kanta. Ka Enta. One Anuswara Enta. And another Anuswara. Vidambana Kanta. Khandi Krita Dasha Kanta. The one who severed 10 heads of Ravana. Khandi Krita Dasha Kanta. Tumburu Nuta Shri Kanta. My Guru's name. I always remember him. Tumburu Nuta Shri Kanta. If he starts singing, Tumburu also should come and salute. such a Srikanta. It's a beautiful kanta. It may be physical or it may be musical. Srikanta. Duritapaha Vaikuntha. Finally, he is not different from Vaikuntha. Nobody should think that Vishnu resides in Vaikuntha. Vishnu himself is Vaikuntha. Vaikuntha is another name of Vishnu. It is not just Vishnu Pada, Vishnu Dhamma. It is Vishnu himself. So he says that Advaita Bhava. Vishnu himself is Vaikuntha, which is Apaha, again, Durita Apaha, which dispels mass of collection, multitudes of papa, sins. Durita is sin. My Durita Apaha, Vaikuntham, Soundararajam. So lyrical, so musical. There is music in the world, and music just supports or heightens the beauty of the world. And the beauty of the world, they blend so well with the musical idea, and they heighten the effect of the musical experience. So this is a kind of amina bhava or unusual combination. You very rarely come across a composition of this nature. Very rare. Perfect blend of sound and sense. Even for those who don't know the meaning of anything, if you sing this song before them, they find it, there is something in it. There is some power in it. There is some vigor in it. There is some charm in it. Something exclusive only to Dikshitar's vision.
Yeah. Thank you.